substitute equation number 3. Masyadong mahaba ito. Dito tayo. So, substitute equation number 3 in equation number 1. So, DE. So, magiging, itong D na ito mapapunta ng ano, equation number 3, which is equals to DC multiplied by cosine of 15 degrees. Cosine 15 degrees over cosine of 75 degrees multiplied by sine of 75 degrees. Okay? Plus DC sine of 15 degrees is equals to 250. So, pag iniquit at lahat dyan, DC is equals to 64.722 kilonewton. Okay? And that is positive. Therefore, tama yung ating assumption na tensile ang ating DC, which is dapat naman talagang maging tensile force kasi cable yung ating structure dito. Okay? Next, kung meron na tayong value for DC, pwede natin substitute ito, okay, sa equation number 3. So, DE is equals to DC, which is equals to 64.722 multiplied by cosine of 15 over cosine of 75 degrees. Therefore, DE is equals to 241.474 kilonewton. Okay? So, meron na tayong DE and DC. So, since meron na tayong DC, pwede na tayong pumunta sa ating joint C. Dahil ang unknown na lamang sa joint C is yung ating tensile for AC and tensile force for BC. Okay? Okay, so punta tayo sa joint C. So, this is x-axis and this is our y-axis. So, ito yung downward na applied force na 100 kilonewton. So, yung ating force DC, gawin na natin kulay black kasi hindi na siya unknown. So, DC is equals to 64.722 kilonewton. So, yung unknown natin is BC, that is tensile force. So, BC, and ito naman, tensile force din na AC. So, this is 80 degrees and this is 15 degrees. So, check natin kung ilan yung mga unknown natin. So, yung ating BC is inclined, therefore it is upward to the right. Okay? So, tanungin nyo rin yung sarili nyo na kung ilan ba yung mga unknown dito. Una, ilan yung ating unknown na horizontal forces? Dalawa. Isang AC at isang horizontal component ng BC. So, wag na muna tayo doon. Ilan naman yung ating unknown na vertical forces? Isa. Okay, that is the vertical component of BC. Therefore, doon na kagad tayo sa solution ng summation of forces, vertical is equal to 0. So, summation of forces, vertical is equal to 0. Upward, upward is positive. So, positive BC multiplied by sine of 80 degrees minus 100 minus DC, which is equals to 64.722 multiplied by sine of 15 degrees is equal to 0. Therefore, ang BC natin multiplied by sine of 80 degrees is equal to 116.751. Therefore, BC is equals to 118.552 kilonewton. Okay? Next, the summation of forces horizontal is equal to 0. To the right is positive. Negative AC plus BC, which is equals to 118.552 multiplied by cosine of 80 degrees plus DC, which is equals to 64.722 multiplied by cosine of 15 degrees is equal to 0. So, AC is equals to 83.103 kilonewton. Okay? So ito yung pag-solve ng ating table analysis under concurrent force system for the equilibrium conditions. Okay? So pwede rin natin gamitin dito yung triangle law kasi dito sa joint D, triangle law, pwede. Kasi ito to naman yung unknown natin. And pwede nyo rin gamitin yung rotation of axis at joint D and at joint C. So nasa inyo kung ano yung mas magandang solution na naangkop doon sa bilis ng inyong pag-solve and kung paano nyo naunawaan yung bawat type of solution. Okay, so that is our problem number 3 for the equilibrium of concurrent force system. So thank you for watching. Bye-bye.